Hey, it's Justin with another tutorial. Today we're going to be making some animated stars all inside After Effects. Let's get started. First thing we're going to do is make a new comp, Command N. Let's do 1920 by 1080, sounds good to me. And 10 seconds is fine for this, and hit OK. Command Y for a new solid. If you need a refresher on some After Effects basics, I have some tutorials that will get you up and running pretty quick. And for tidiness sake, let's rename this layer. Let's call it Stars. Surprise, surprise. Next, we're going to have some fun with Fractal Noise, which is a fantastic way to generate a variety of textures without very much work. We're going to bump up the contrast, maybe somewhere in the 600s. Now take the brightness down around negative 200. And if you are working in higher than 8 bits per channel, we should clip these HDR results because this is so contrasty. That way we don't get any negative pixel values when we try to blend mode this on top of something else later on down the road. Now twirl down the transform properties and slide the scale down. Depending on how dense you want this star field to be, usually 1 or 2% works pretty good. If you're not liking the look of the stars, try tweaking some of the settings a bit until it suits your needs. For starters, you can change the random seed down here in the evolution options to get some different placement. Now, these stars are looking a little too harsh for my taste. One thing we can do is add a slight blur to it. That way these aren't as harsh once we zoom back to 100. So 1.5 pixels ought to do it. All right, on to animating this. Let's make these new little stars twinkle. This evolution parameter here is where all the magic happens. All you need to do is animate this value over time, and boom, you have twinkly stars. There's a few ways to do this. There's always handy-dandy expressions, which help automate this, or good old-fashioned keyframes. For this animation, I want it to loop seamlessly, so I'm going to do keyframes because that's simpler in this scenario. A seamless loop means that I can play the animation over and over again and there won't be a jump cut when it starts over. Go to the first frame, hit the home on the keyboard, and click the evolution stopwatch to set a keyframe. Now we're going to jump to the end of the composition, the last frame, and then page down to go one more further. With the playhead at the end of the frame, plus one, we can set another keyframe. Now the trick here is to move in 360-degree increments, or whole cycles. Our first keyframe was at 0 degrees, so we need to make sure that this is the same. Let's start with 3 for now. And while we are in the neighborhood, let's also check the cycle evolution. Now this checkbox is the secret sauce. If you don't check it, the loop won't work. What this is going to do is allow the fractals to visually loop back on themselves when they finish a complete cycle, hence why we need to do full 360-degree increments. So if we did this right, the first frame, should be 0 degrees, should look strikingly similar to the last frame, which is just shy of 360 degrees. And the next frame, 0 again. Cool, that means we've got a good loop. So here's a star field. You can use it as a background, add some nebulas or planets or something. You could comp it in over a sky replacement. You could put the Star Wars crawl on top of it, whatever your little heart desires. So this is one quick and easy way to make stars all in After Effects, and I hope this was helpful.